everyone, and welcome back to our channel. It has been, I think, 5 months. Terrible. I have really been slacking, but there has been a lot of stuff going on. And don't worry, I'm gonna get you guys all caught up so you can know exactly what's been going on, where we've been, things like that. I just really wanted to come on and tell everyone Merry Christmas. Yes, today is Christmas Day. It is December 25th. It's actually Christmas night. It is 9:36 at night, but I wanted to come on and tell everyone Merry Christmas. I hope you guys are having a very Merry Christmas, and your holiday season thus far has been, you know, nothing short of amazing. I had to run out and get a couple of things from the gas station, from the only gas station that is open where I live. I don't care what's going on. Sheets never let me down. They never let me down. So I had to run out to Sheets and pick up a few things from Sheets. So like I said, I hope everyone is having a very Merry Christmas. I hope everyone had an awesome day today. Spend a lot of time with your families. If you're someone who's struggling during the Christmas holidays, I hope you're taking good care of yourself. You know, mental health wise, I hope you're taking really good care of yourself. So I will see you guys in the morning. Again, Merry Christmas, and I'll see you guys in the morning. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back. So it is December 26th, the day after Christmas. I actually just left my office. I just saw a client. I had to tie up some loose ends with her this morning. But when I say my office, I don't mean DSS, because you guys know that I'm a children's services social worker for the Department of Social Services, but I didn't just leave there. I'm actually on vacation from there until January the 7th, but I just left my personal office, Your Way Life Coaching and Consulting. So I saw a client this morning. Now I'm actually on my way. I have to go to the market and pick up a couple of things. And then I have to go get my son from basketball practice and back home and finish the girl's hair. And later this afternoon, Lucky and I, we have to meet our realtor. So let me just give you guys like a crash course catch up on what's been going on. Okay, so first of all, our wedding. You know, everyone knows we had our wedding in Nigeria. We did not have a wedding in the U.S. So we're planning our wedding, our U.S. wedding here. We actually started planning it 2 months ago. And it's going to be in October. So would it be in December? We have 10 months left before it gets here. And we waited. Well, we're pushing it out so long. First of all, we got married in October. The wedding date, the date that we're going to have our wedding on here, is not our actual anniversary, but it's really close to it. Our anniversary is actually on a weekday, and because of work and everything, we had to put the wedding on a weekend, so we couldn't get married on our actual anniversary. I mean, but it's okay. And most of our friends and families work and things like that, so it was going to be kind of difficult for us to do that. We pushed it out for a whole year. We start planning, like I said, in October, because I don't call myself a perfectionist. However, it's just some things that when I see weddings, it's just some things that I want and I'm not going to settle for, because I can go to a wedding and tell if there's something that they just planned 2-3 months ago. And my thing is this: give yourself time to plan. And if you can't afford certain things, don't go for certain things. Because the last thing I'm going to do is have a wedding here and it'd be a whole hot mess. I'm not gonna do that. So and my friends and my family, they are very honest and upfront. They'll tell me, Constance, that was a whole hot mess. You shouldn't have done that. And I tell them too, that's just our relationship. It is what it is. We are very upfront and honest with each other. So I'm planning the wedding. We're also looking for another house. This will be the last time we're moving for a long time. Now we're settled, and our rental house, and you know, it's a cute little house, it's a cute little neighborhood, love the neighborhood, love the house. However, it's too many of us. Guys, when I say that we have stuff, and you will see, when I say that we have stuff everywhere, stuff is in every room of the house, every closet of the house. The garage is packed. We have storage, I mean, just jam-packed. We don't even have enough space to park vehicles at the rental house. We don't. But, you know, before looking at other houses, we were kind of looking at things and, you know, either like in the neighborhood or like in everything about the house. I feel that we settled a lot on some other stuff. I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm never, ever, ever going to settle again, especially when it comes to such a huge purchase as that. Because we did, I do believe that we settled and we didn't get everything we want. So now we're looking again, and this is going to be the last move for a very long time. What else has been going on? Yeah, I am starting to see, we're going to a fertility specialist. After the last miscarriage I had, that was a lot, you know, on us. So we, our first appointment is actually, I think it's January the 18th. I think that's what it is. I have to look at my phone, but I think it's January the 18th, because we have a lot of questions. We got to know like what's going on and why things are happening the way they're happening. I'm sorry about the glare, guys, the sun, and I don't think my camera is focusing the way that it should. So, you know, we're going through that because we're just one more, and then we are done. One more. So we're done with that, and I have like the business stuff going on, looking for another location for the office, because that space isn't big enough, and I don't know if we're going to buy a space or keep leasing a space. So we're gonna see how that works out, because we're putting out a lot of money on so much stuff. So yeah, we're looking at that. And then talking to, you know, my doctor, she also suggested that I lose at least 50 to 60 pounds. So I'm working on that too. So, you know, have a lot going on. My days usually start like at 4 o'clock in the morning, and sometimes they end 11, 12 o'clock at night. So there really hasn't been a lot of time for filming anything. I just have not had the time to do it. So now we're back, and you know, we're going to make this work. So like I said, I'm going to the market, and then we have the realtor to meet with this afternoon. I really need to go to the bank, but I don't feel like fooling with that today. I'll do that tomorrow. So we're going to go to the market, and I'll take you guys along as much as I can. Sometimes some places here, you know, stores get a little bit funny about people recording in their facilities, especially if you're walking around with a, you know, a camera in your hand, because I don't record on my phone, because I don't want to take all my memory up. So you walk around with a camera and with a big old huge microphone attached to it, people are like, what are you doing in here with that? So yeah, with me being in a small town in North Carolina. So but yeah. So, I'm going to take y'all along, and we're going to see what I get into today. All right. Hey, guys. So, Walmart was a whole hot mess. I mean, an entirely hot mess. I should have known better than going in there the day after Christmas, because people are returning things. And I purchased some things, but I didn't even purchase what I went in the store for. I purchased some makeup brushes that were on sale for $7. They usually were around $14, $15. And then I purchased some lavender honey and tea tree soap. They had it like in a Christmas combo. The Christmas items are now 50% off. So they had it like a little Christmas combo. It was usually around $10-$11 with tax. So I got it for $4.47, $4.48, something like that. And usually I don't purchase a lot of soaps and stuff. Usually I like to make my own stuff, because I like to control what goes in and on my body. But with those, I decided to purchase it. Let me cut this volume down on here. I actually, you see I'm using the GPS on my cell phone, because when I was coming out of Walmart, I actually got an text message from my realtor, and it was two properties that she sent over to me. And I wasn't far from them. I'm literally like 4 minutes away from one of them right now. So I'm going to drive and take a look at it, because if I don't see what I like in the outside, I don't want to see the inside, because there are certain outside space we want and inside space we want. And there's a certain way we want the yard to be in a certain neighborhoods and stuff like that. So if the outside ain't what I'm looking for, we're not even going to look at the inside. And one thing about my husband, if you know Lucky, you know he's going to be like, my wife didn't like it, I'm not even going to waste my time. So he's actually at home sleeping, but until I get there and wake him up. But you know, he's just always like, if she doesn't like it, I'm not wasting my time. Good man, happy wife, happy life, great man, love him. Yeah, so I'm going to drive over here. I am 3 minutes out, and to see what they have, and that is that. So we're gonna see what's going on here. Yep. And I hope this video isn't going to be too choppy, because we're doing well. I'm doing so much stuff today, and a lot of it is in the car driving, because we have to go so many places, and I like to drive. I don't really like Lucky to drive me places, because he likes to drive like he's in a Fast and Furious movie, and I want to live. So I always tell him, baby, you're driving like you're in Nigeria. You're not in Nigeria, boo. You're in North Carolina. You can't drive like that. You go kill us all. And he's like, just calm down and let me do this. And I'm like, hell no, I'm not calming down. This is my life. We ain't about to play these damn games. But whatever. So I am almost there. And I don't know from seeing where it's turning me into. I don't think I like this neighborhood. Yeah, I'm not a fan. This is one of the homes that I saw online, and I like the pictures that's for sale that I just passed by. This is a nice established neighborhood, however, it's not a, I don't know, let's see, because I've never driven far back in it. So let me see where my GPS is taking me, and let me see if I'm gonna roll with it, because I don't know. Let my sir. I think this is gonna be a nope. I mean, I like the neighborhood, but the yard space really doesn't. Oh, that's the other one that I saw that was for sale. Why everybody in this neighborhood is selling their damn houses? What's going on over here? Why every damn thing over here for sale? That's what I want to know. Because I'm not going to pull up in my neighborhood and I'm purchasing, and then I feel like, I'm not going to say what I'm thinking. I'm going to be nice today. Okay, so let's see. Now that I turn through here, what the yard space looks like. Oh! See, now that's huge. Let me see. Is this right here? I didn't realize it was so much back here. And back here, you can tell a different builder started back here, because all these homes, they're not cookie cutter. They look different. And the yard space is amazing. Okay. Yeah. I done passed the house. I'm just driving and just looking around and seeing. But do I want to be? Because a lot is still being built here. I don't think I want to deal with that bullshit. Ugh. I think I do. And guys, you guys have to excuse me. I said I was working on my my choice of words and not use profanities as much. I'm working on it. I can't make no promises. Can't make no promises. Some of this shit looks weird. I'm not even about to deal with this. Let me go, because I done passed the damn house and turned the other way. Okay, so let's see. But the house itself is really fucking nice. It is. I'm going to show you guys what the house looks like. Let's see. I hope you guys can see it. It's really nice.
Your son is attempting to reach you on your cellular device. You have an in...
Yes, son. Are you done?
Yeah, we done.
Huh?
We done.
You are? Okay, well, I'm coming.
Yeah.
All right, I'll be there in a minute. So, let's see. This is what it looks like. I hope you guys can see that.
Call ended.
Yeah, the house itself is nice. But I don't know. We're going to see. But I had to drive around. But it looks shit. It looks like you're going to be able to, freaking build. I should have just flipped my camera around instead of picking it up. That was stupid. But it looks like you're going to be able to build right beside. Oh, I'm not about to deal with that shit. I can tell you that right now. That ain't what we gonna do. So I can tell her this is a damn no.
No.
Not about to deal with that. So. They were done quick. It's like I just dropped that damn dude off. Ain't about to deal with that. Some neighborhoods already don't be a damn no when I go up in them. But I just be like, let me see. But I don't want to go into a neighborhood. This is the only thing about neighborhood living, because some of your neighbors are trashy as hell, and I don't want to deal with that. I'm okay with a HOA and all of that stuff. Hell yeah, I'm gonna pay it, because they keep your ass regulated. This is what you can and can't do. I am definitely okay with the HOA, because they are going to regulate your ass and regulate what you do and don't do in your yard. Because honey, let me tell you, when I pulled in the neighborhood, the first house I drove by that welcomed you into the neighborhood after the one that was for sale, a damn junk car right there. Who wants to see that bullshit? Pull that shit out your yard, or either put it in your garage if you're working on it. I understand you paying for your home, but don't nobody want to see that. You know, a bunch of junk cars and a bunch of broken kid toys, just a bunch of shit in the yard. That's the only thing that when we were out in the country, we didn't have to worry about that, because I don't want to see that. And that foolishness brings your damn property value down. I don't want to see that. So that's the only thing that gets me about neighborhood living. I do want to be in a neighborhood that has an HOA that controls that bullshit. Because, girl, honey, let me tell you, I don't have time, because I've been knocking on your door. Can you get this bullshit out your yard? Well, if my house is close to yours, or my house isn't close to yours, I don't care. Because, and then that type of stuff can have, like, I don't know what the hell is wrong with my bra, but it won't stay where I put it. Then that type of stuff also can attract, like, bugs and critters that belong out in the woods. Oh, no time for that, because if you know me, you know I am not dealing with that bullshit. That was really one of the main reasons we left our house in the country. Because let me tell you something, when I go outside and stuff moving, and we live out in the country and there's nothing behind us and trees and shit moving, and I have a firearm. Look, if you back there and I shoot your ass, you deserve to be shot, because that means you back there trying to do something to me, because you ain't got no business in the back of my yard. But I'm telling you guys, so much stuff, and I'm like, every time I would come home at night, all the lights would be on. I would see little animals and I would be like, what the hell is that? The only thing that I would know when I'm looking at deer. The deer never bother me. I used to leave corn out to feed the deer. I love deer. They mind their own business if I'm driving by. I know sometimes deers jump out in front of people's vehicles and all that stuff. But the deer, they never bother me. I guess they say, shit, that lady feed us. That lady leave us food outside. Let's not fuck with her. So, you know, but yeah. But other than that, no. There was this thing on my porch one time, and I videoed it. I would never upload it because I know there will probably be some animal people out here in the world that are be very upset with me. But yeah, I don't know what that damn thing was. May his soul rest in peace, that's all I can say. But yeah, don't know what that thing was. And my husband didn't know what it was, but he looked at it, he was like, I grew up in Nigeria and I've seen so much shit, but I never seen no shit that looked like this. He didn't even know what it was. But like I said, that's a video that you guys will never see, because I never upload that. So little thing was in the wrong place at the wrong time. I don't know what it was, but the claws were like this damn long. Like, no freaking exaggeration. The teeth on that thing, I was like, oh, hell no. Yeah, it's time for me to go. I'm not about to stay. I stay in the hotel first. Paying the mortgage and living in the hotel. Ain't about to do that. So yeah, I am done with country living. I had to come back into civilization where there are people and it's well established. I don't want any more animals. I don't want to be on any other animals' turf. Little animals, y'all ain't got to worry about me there messing with you guys. Y'all ain't got to worry about that. I'm not coming back where any of you guys live. Y'all can have all of that. I'm going to stay where humans belong. Y'all stay where animals belong. So, guys, after I picked Cam up from practice today, the plan was to come home, wake Lucky up, and we go see houses with our realtor. Right? Wrong. I picked him up, I came home, and I crashed. Lucky's actually at work. I was asleep when he went to work, which makes me so upset because I hate when I don't see him or talk to him before he goes to work. But look who I have beside me, who I can't never get rid of.
Hey.
Who is this?
Nadia.
Nadia. So what you been up to, shorty?
Doing my hair and playing games and playing with my dogs. And actually getting ready for this video.
Yeah. So I think we are going to end the video here. But we are going to shoot and upload another video tomorrow. But we want you guys to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you are notified when we upload new videos. Anything you need to say, Miss Lady?
I'm just saying, why are we ending so soon?
Well, it's not soon to me because I already shot some footage today. It's soon to you, but not to me.
Okay, let me talk. Okay. So, as you know, y'all didn't know.
Okay.
So, guess what? We have a shirt thing that my mom can make shirts with. We're going to make our own shirts, and that's going to be our merch. But then, we're going to make hoodies out of them and put a little heart and triangle. One is going to have a triangle on, and one is going to have a heart on them. And then, we're going to be selling some merch. Phone cases. Mom, I can see you.
I know you can see me, but that ain't what we gonna do.
Well, Chad Wear Clay and V Quentin do that, and I think we'll do it. If y'all know Chad Wear Clay and V Quentin, click that down below and go watch some of their videos.
You're not gonna click that down below because I'm not linking their videos down below, so they're not gonna click it. If it doesn't have anything to do with us, we're not clicking it down below. It's not down below, boo. It's not linked. It's not linked.
Whatever the word is, I'm still gonna do it. She's a really nice sleeper.
We will see you guys later in our next video. Have a great night.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Love you guys.
Dance, dance, dance. The beauty in your eyes, they give me life. Oh, oh. I could give the love, the thanks. Oh, what you say? Hey, hey.